miss seeing all of you at GL every day, but I hope that you're staying active at home. I'm staying active by walking around this lake in my neighborhood every day. I hope to see you all soon, and good luck, Mr. Scarra, on your run.
YMCA! YMCA!
Hi everybody, Rob Nixon here. We want to give a shout out to my man Mike Scarra. Good luck to you on your 781 lap run. Very proud of a great thing that you're doing to try and help others. With me today are
Brooke Nixon
and
Bobby Nixon.
And we're going to show you how we start our 100 catch challenge as an example of how we're staying active while at home together. What we'll try and do is using a softball and a baseball is complete 100 consecutive catches and throws without dropping the ball. We won't bore you by keeping you here for the whole thing, but we're going to show you how we get it started. Ready, guys?
Yep.
Let's go. Brooke, you first. One. Two.
I've been out here all afternoon just trying to hit the ball, and I've swung and missed so many times. I'm going to try this again. Oh my gosh, that's 50K. Boy, I hope I can hit one. There it goes! Inside the park, home run. Home run, get it? Through.
Helping hand, I'll be there on the double as fast as I can.
everybody. It's Mrs. Oliveira. I hope you're doing well. Miss you so much and hope to get to see you soon. Just wanted to... Oh, there's my sidekick over here. This is Jessica. Can you say hi?
Hi!
Just wanted to show you a little bit of what I'm doing to stay active as we support Mr. Scarras. He runs a 50K in his backyard. As you can see, I have a 3-year-old daughter, so we are out and about as much as possible, getting some fresh air, blowing bubbles. We planted a garden. We go for walks. We play fetch with my golden retriever. There she is, Maggie. There she is. And all around, just trying to stay busy, stay active, and get some sunshine when we can. So, again, hope to see all of you soon. And good luck, Mr. Scarra. We'll see you guys, okay? Bye.
Hey everyone, Coach Coughlin here, trying to give you a little bit of coaching tip as we watch Mike Scarra do his phenomenal feat of 50K in his backyard. Just keep going making turns, Mr. Scarra. You're going to be great. So my tip actually comes not from me, but comes from the legendary coach, Jumbo Elliott. Most people in the tri-state area know Jumbo Elliott from the Giants and the Jets fame, the football player. But this Jumbo Elliott, just caught a leaf. This Jumbo Elliott created the dynasty in the track and field world at the collegiate level. But back in the 40s through the 80s, the East Coast also had a powerhouse, and that was Villanova. So Jumbo Elliott was a great coach for about 45 years. Through his time there, they were able to win 8 national team championships. He had 82 individual NCAA champions, 66 world records, and 28 of his athletes became Olympians, 5 of which got gold medals. And this man who has done such great things, he was a small, was a framed guy, but he had a powerful aura about himself. People who knew him said he spoke with anger in his voice, and he was tough and strong. And through this strong, powerful guy comes this really great quote. And it's actually the opposite of what you would think of him. Although he was tough and he demanded, very demanding of his athletes, he also was famous for one saying, which I think is really important for us to remember. He told his athletes to smell the roses. Smell the roses. It's important to, when you're running out there, to enjoy it. Enjoy what you do. Enjoy the sights and the sounds. The flowers coming out. Enjoy running with your companions when we're able to join up again. Enjoy the water trickling in the stream, hopping over some streams. Running through the woods, hearing the crackling of leaves underneath your feet. Feeling the air go around your head as you're going faster. Doing a great job, but getting out there and enjoying and feeling it. So Jumbo Elliott wants you to do that. And I think it's important when you go running, not to put the ear pads and ear pods in your ears. You know, keep the music out. Enjoy the sounds and the scenery around you. It's also important to take those out because you can hear yourself breathe better. And knowing your breathing habits can help you become a more efficient runner. You can hear your feet Are they stomping the ground? Are you light on your feet? And then ultimately, it's also important to hear around you when we're on the streets. Believe it or not, we use our ears a lot when we cross the streets. You know, sometimes we don't look both ways before we cross. We don't use our eyes. We hear if there's a car not coming or not, and we could just go. So go out there and enjoy the run. Mike, enjoy your backyard. Listen to the birds. Stop and smell the roses every so often. Good luck to you all. Talk to you again soon.